Swapping machine so that I could use a hamster's tiny little hands to assemble circuit boards. So we just need to swap Pieface's mind with someone who's really good at maths. I mean, I would show you all of my math certificates, but unfortunately, I've scrunched them all up and stored them in my cheeks for the winter. Oops, I forgot to lock this cage. Body, come back!
You don't need to do all this for me. I've got a plan.
Yes, but my plan is better. We just swap your brain with Screwtops. Nothing could possibly go wrong. Sensation. I feel at one with the earth. And delicious with baked beans and grated cheese.
It's gone wrong. Switch them back.
No, wait. This might be better. Mrs. Creature might have noticed if Pieface started talking in a funny accent, but...
But a potato talking in a funny accent, that's totally normal.
Hey, why don't you mean a funny accent?
Now the prof can sit on Pieface's desk and help do the test disguised as Paul.
And afterwards, I get to write a Nobel Prize winning paper on what it feels like to be a potato.
Come on! Don't you stay over!
Some sort of transmitter in his potato.
He hasn't, Walter.
But I heard it giving him the answers.
Potatoes can't talk, Walter. I've been trying to teach Peter that for years.
Well, actually, does that ball of paper mean I should stop talking, Dennis?
I didn't throw any paper at Pieface, but if I did, it would mean stop talking, yes.
Times 24 is 48.
Pieface, just go with the plan you had. You can do it.
That went brilliantly.
You see? I told you my plan would work.
Oh no, your plan didn't. The potato professor fell asleep halfway through the test.
What? I couldn't help it. Oh, the test was so easy. I got bored. Although carbohydrates make me drowsy, and I am now super carby.
What do you get if you cross an aeroplane with a magician?
I don't know. What do you get if you cross an aeroplane with a magician?
Whatever the potato gets it!
answers, and I'm going to find out how.
I'd go to...
I know where he might be.
Pinoland Theme Park. We'll start with the Big Dipper.
I can't believe I'm asking this, but where do you think your potato would go if it grew legs?
Don't worry, Paul. The nice brain swap machine will get you out of this smelly old professor's body.
My dad is not smelly.
He is a bit smelly, eating all that soil.
A brain swap machine? So... Pieface was cheating. Bertie, call Sergeant Slipper. We'll get Pieface expelled, break up Dennis's gang, confiscate the machine and use it ourselves to become billionaires.
Well, we've had a great time at Beanoland Theme Park, but no sign of the pro... Oh.
Yes, Pieface was right. Good thing we listened to him, eh?
Oh, yeah.
The Helder Schelder was amazing. Being a potato is the best. Way back to the anonymous tip-off from Walter that you have been conducting unlicensed brain transfers between humans and root vegetables.
Prove it!
It's got us there, hasn't he? I can't see anything strange going on here. Ta-da!
This is a mind-swapping machine, and I can prove it! Watch! Stop, potato! Talk!
I think we should demonstrate the brain swap device for Walter.
Okay, Pieface. And why should we do that?
Because I'd like to try swapping brains with you, Dennis. Or anyone else who's nearby.
Yes, Dennis. Maybe you should listen to Pieface. Sounds like a plan.
You mean you and me swap brains? But I'll need Walter's help.
Numbers were little potatoes.
You did very well, Pete.